Sick of losing money? Well, knowing the market direction is ultimately key. But there's no secret indicator, there's no secret formula for you to get success in a financial market. In this video, I'm going to show you how to stop losing money, not so much on trades or investments, wasting it in market conditions like this, where you can just stand still and wait for things to play out a little bit more than you should. So the Bitcoin chart, hello. Bit of a hybrid video this one. We're going to do market sentiment and we're also going to do some educational stuff. Five things I want to give you in this, you'll enjoy it, trust me. Now we're in a downtrend, we're forming these swingy horrible lows. Basically we had a bit of a sideways motion in the middle and then we had a pop to the upside, then we create this new low. Problem is, we've created a new low. Now the first thing I want to explain to you guys is ignore the noise. You can see here on the screen, Twitter. Stuff like this gets on my tits. It really does. Giving you that analysis, giving you that bias of one thing will hurt you eventually because you are being misled off basically data that shouldn't really be used, in my opinion. What is happening? Well, when we're looking at the market, we're in a downtrend on higher time frames. Now, the one thing we need to talk about, and it's vitally important, weekly time frame, to me, looks clear cut. We've had 8 red candles, blue in my case. We are going to bounce. Boys and girls, whether you like it or not, we're going to bounce very, very soon, I think. For me, if we're going to look at this as a weekly level structure, ignore the Fibonacci on here. This is a bigger play. This is over a period of weeks, months, half a year, whatever you want to describe as, right? We could be going lower. But even if that is the case, knowing the trend direction is also very, very important because I'm going to explain to you this one. We could very easily go up into this little pocket. The reason why I say that is because we've got another play here. We've got an impulse here from this swing high to this swing low. We could be pulling back in. Get people motivated, right? Hype, liquidity, right? Markets will always move in that sort of vein. So if we're looking at this swing high here, to this swing low, we could very easily, now not to kind of teach you how to suck eggs here, very easily go to 40k, very easily on this swing here. Pretty straightforward, right, overall? But it may not happen, right? The reason being, we may actually stop here, about 34k, which I think 34k is more likely. But the reason why I say that even that might not happen is because of what is happening in the financial markets. The trend is your friend. You've got to go with it, right? Now, if I just remove some of the noise here. So we've got that on the overall swing. If you're looking at the daily time frame as well, you're going to have trends within trends. The FOMC update here was this big, massive dump. That is where things went a bit ropey for us. We could do a Fibonacci from that swing high as well and ultimately see where that can lead us. 34K is a 618 level on here. It's also in confluence with the previous one I've just showed you. But also 31,000, give or take, around that level is also hugely important. So remember the trend, right? We are going down, but we may well zip back up into those regions. And yeah, things get a little bit more drastic, essentially, for some people. You do not want to be the late bull or the late bear in any of this situation. Which brings me on to number 3, risk management. Whoa, hugely important, this one. Hugely important. Now, some people tend to believe that if you go long or short and you get liquidated, game over. No. Most traders are very, very clever. They use a basis of between 0.5%, 1%, maybe even 2% risk most of the time if you're on high leverage. Some people use 3 to 5%, give or take, but ultimately it's down to you, right? If you're on spot, be careful. Often the spot triggers on stop losses are nowhere near as good. However, when you're looking at this, people will be looking to short this bottom area to go longer, to go further down, sorry. But people also will be looking to long much higher, which is where I got the problem. Long in resistance and short in support is not the way through. You need to flip that upside down. Why? Because it's a logic, right? You need to buy the lows and then sell the highs, right? Which also brings me on to the obvious, buying. Risk management buying. I get asked a lot of questions throughout the day, throughout whatever time period. I get, are you buying? Well, I'll buy if it's a key level. Let me explain. Looking at BTC, for me, We've got to look at the obvious. Where has things been where it's likely to revisit? Here. 26,000, 25,000, give or take around that point. Certainly on this chart, it went to that level. I know on other charts, it's gone to different levels. But ultimately for me, you want to go where the market is telling you where things have been before. The past is always a good basis for the future. Now, you can't tell the future, but you can look at the past to give you an idea. Now, that's why trends and Fibonacci, you know, reference points realistically are hugely important. Now, we look at this. Zooming in on all this stuff here, people be like, well, why are you saying that? What? These are levels for potential future. If you've got good risk management, you'll know that they're a level for interest. Risk management in this case is have some money just in case. Why would you want to buy and go all in around this point when the likelihood is we're going to go lower? That is the point here. Probability, not certainties, probability. So we need to be careful with that. The next one we need to talk about is taking profits. Yes, we need to take profit here. Because in this scenario as well, when we're analysing Bitcoin, what if we do go up and retest into this region, go to 40k, and then we start coming back down? Would it not be wise to take some money off the table? Now, I'm not talking about Bitcoin specifically here. I'm talking about the altcoins. BTC is the motion of the market. If you look at BTC versus everything, it's all looking the same right now. Most of the things not looking great. BTC not looking great, not moving much in the weekends. Cool, right? But if you've got an altcoin, and an altcoin's done 20, 30, 40, even 60% potentially because they've done some massive drops, you want to take profit, right? Well, I hope you do say that and think that. The percentage numbers that you make on that downturn is going to make you more and more wealth, because number five is obvious. Reinvest. Reinvest your capital, man. Because when you've taken profit and then you've got some money extra, and I'm not saying just sell all of it. I'm just saying take 10% out, take 25%, take 50%, depending on your risk management and your risk appetite. You've got more to buy lower. In altcoins, you can get more alts. You can get more units. Units are key in a bear market. Now, we are overall in a downtrend. We have formed the most clearest of lows ever with no sign of reversal yet. The only thing we're going to see at the moment, right now, time of recording, speculating, a push to the upside because we've dropped that much. People are going to buy. And ultimately, it could be a trap. It could be a very, very nice, neat trap for further liquidity to get pushed in and around this region for us to go even lower. Now, if we do go to 20K, if we do go to 13K, now these are not predictions, they're just obvious kind of reference points, as I've said just before, you may want to have some money just in case we go down there. You do not want to be that influencer, that person, that plonker who's literally bought everything at one level because someone else has said so. So it's hugely important. But yeah, for me, most people are losing money by those five things and not getting them right. And the most important thing is they're just not waiting. Be patient. Patience is absolutely key here. So yeah, if you like my stuff, watch the next video recommended for you. Might help you out. But I'll be back on Friday.